And alrighty, so I'm going to try to do a quick pull of my good buddy here on his Turbo Busa before it gets too dark out. I'm sure he'll spank me, but it's good to see what the heck the V4 Speciale can do up against a Turbo Busa. It's not that often that you encounter one of these things on the streets. I mean, you hear about him running wild all over the place. But this is my good buddy that actually owns one. He's super tall like me. He's actually taller. Dude's over 6'6" in height, so he needs a Turbo Busa. Before I get all these questions asking, this is not Turbo Warren. This is another one of my good buddies from the filthy Cleveland area. Repsol edition. My rider that weighs tremendously less than me. Got him. Clean race. So now I have a ZX10 race. I think he wants another slacking. I'll smack him down again. Got him! Got him! Got him! This is like taking candy from a baby! Oh boy. He wants more? More shellackens? Got him! Got him! Got him! Got him! Got him! ZX10RR, no match! Absolutely no match! For the Ducati V4 Speciale! You guys are making me upset! They're making me smack these guys down all night long! I got better things to do! To prove a point that you can't fuck with this bike! What are you gonna learn? So check out these amazing Hondas. CBR1000RRs. Beautiful bikes that I just had the privilege of dancing with. They're fast, don't get me wrong, but just not quite to the level of the Ducati V4. Close though, but just not quite there just yet. The Ducati V4 still reigns supreme. Let's talk to one of the jockeys of the Hondas as they're doing Instagram stuff. Yo, so what do you think about the V4 after our little smackdown?
Fast.
Fast?
Yeah. You can't say anything, man, about that bike.
Mm-hmm.
That bike is really fast.
How much do you weigh? Ralph, don't go anywhere.
185.
185?
Yep.
Okay.
Yes.
So you got me by 40 pounds.
Yeah.
And a lot of height and weight and all that, and width and all that, but I was still able to put the smack down.
Yeah, but that bike is fast.
Well, thanks, man. I appreciate it. Ralph, I'll catch you, man. So check out this beautiful M2, beautiful Long Beach blue color. What's the horsepower, man?
It's about 365.
Wow.
Yeah.
Twin turbo?
Single turbo.
Single turbo. Okay. Inline six?
Inline six.
Mm-hmm.
365. It has an overboost, so it'll have 369 torque.
Is this the one that has the fluid in the trunk? You could put, is that a different one? One of these
no,
BMWs.
I think that's a different one.
Yeah.
It's not this one.
Okay.
But, I mean, it's set up for the track. It has an oil cooler and everything.
How fast you had it?
About 140.
On the track, of course.
Yes.
In Mexico. In Mexico, yeah. So he's hanging out. I love the dual exhaust. Wow. It's gorgeous. So he's hanging out with us. We got all the biker guys here. So my main man here on the Turbo Busa is ready for action. How tall are you?
6'9".
6'9 and 245 pounds.
45.
Wow. So you pretty much had to get a turbo just to be competitive with folks, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Size absolutely matters.
Mm-hmm.
Very competitive.
Yep. Wow. 6'9". Who's 5'9" here? Who is he?
I'm 5'6".
You're 5'6". So he's more than a foot taller than you. Wow.
5'5".
5'5"?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah, look at that. Wow.
I can hide behind
him. Yeah.
Yep.
No, no, Jim.
I gotta stop that wheelie out of second, man.
Pull over, and get on this bike, Jim.
All
right. Hold on, we're gonna pull over. What you got for me? Wow. All right, so I'm riding a ZX10 RR. My first time riding this bike. See what it's all about. This bike is so tiny. Much smaller, even compared to my V4. And the gauges, well, you know how I feel about the ZX10 gauges. Absolutely horrible. Definitely hope they change these gauges when they restyle this motorcycle, which hopefully is coming soon. Throttle response is real nice. This bike has this ECU flash from my good buddy Don Gould. The throttle feels great. Brakes are great. ZX10 has always had great brakes. Mac, what happened when you and Donnie raced? Donnie got you?
Okay.
What?
Yeah.
You beat Mac?
I did.
Hey, Donnie beat him. Oh my God.
He
I didn't know that.
He's stocked. I thought we were going to figure this.
No, I saw the takeoff. They look kind of even. And then Donnie did a little baby wheelie. So I thought the race was over.
Oh, yeah. Fast kept going.
Wow.
I think
he
did a little.
Put a pretty good distance.
I think I was
lot of low end and a lot of top end.
Wow, the Ducati does, huh? A lot of low and top end. Well, I was surprised, Donnie. Did you, how many bikes did you beat him by?
I don't know, but I felt like I pulled away from him.
5, 6, 7, and it was increasing?
No.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, that bike's an animal.
Can you remove your helmet so the viewers can hear you more clearly? So what do you think about the V4, Donnie? It's your first time riding it.
That bike's an animal.
Wow.
It's a duck. It was quacking like a duck. It quacks.
Wow.
And it's an animal. It's got a lot of power.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm very impressed with it.
What do you think about the quick shift and auto blipper?
Very smooth.
Mm-hmm.
Very smooth.
Yeah.
Effortless.
Wow.
Like butter.
Yeah.
Smooth like butter.
And the gauges and stuff like that?
Gauges are precise and you know, very visible. Yeah. I like that.
I forgot to explain to you the shift light. Did you figure out when it turns yellow, that's your shift light?
I did.
Okay.
I did. I had to learn that real quickly. it was very powerful. I didn't expect it to be that powerful.
Wow.
And upstairs too.
Yeah.
I like that a lot. It just kept climbing and kept going.
I'd like to see you. Next we have to see you race Mustang Dame on the H2. I want to see that tonight.
I'll do it.
Yeah, we'll do that right now. He's gonna race you on the H2.
I need about 10 bike heads start.
No, let's do a fair one first. I'll flag it and then.
No, there ain't gonna be. I don't think I have anything.
With your weight?
No, not with the power that Mustang Dame's H2 puts out.
Yeah.
But it definitely is. To me, I don't think
they go back and forth almost on H2s. Right. So. Yeah. The viewers want to see it though. The viewers want to see it. Yeah.
When they took off, I took off after. Pull it hard.
Yeah.
Hard.
Especially with Donnie on it. Wow. So now let's talk about the ZX10 RR Milton. Sternerway just annihilated me.
Annihilated
me. There might be something going on with your tune.
Yeah.
Or with your exhaust. What type of exhaust?
TaylorMade exhaust.
Yeah, those exhausts don't produce any power, man. So that could be
it
right there.
I got it for the look, but
we'll
find out.
Yeah. My good buddy, Lord Jeffrey, had a TaylorMade at first as well, and his S1000, and he realized it wasn't making power, so he switched to a different exhaust. That might be what you need to do.
Okay. All right.
To get more power. I might suggest the Brox Predator exhaust would be a good one for this bike. Because Sternerway should not have beaten me as bad as he did on his S1000. Yeah. Yeah. We've got youngsters enjoying a friendly game of volleyball down here at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame here in the midnight hours. What a great place to be able to enjoy volleyball in the cloak of darkness in downtown filthy Cleveland. But guess what? The V4 Speciale is also here, and it is looking rather stunning against the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Cleveland skyline. Beautiful evening here, crystal clear skies. Gorgeous, gorgeous night. And the V4 Speciale held its own against a CBR 1000 RR SP edition, a 2018 ZX10R. And you know, I won one race against my good buddy on his Turbo Busa. Lost four, but won one. That was pretty epic racing indeed. Check out the new Rage Cycle. Fender Eliminator, integrated turn signals, courtesy of Moto Million. They look very nice on the Speciale. We also have the beautiful RapidTech carbon fiber wheels, which helped this bike accelerate to epic speeds, courtesy of Brox Performance. The Akrapovic exhaust, which is different on each side. This is how it looks on the right side. Let's stroll over to the left side, and if you can see that, it sort of hangs underneath the bike on the left. I think that's pretty cool. You know, I'd never noticed that until like I bought the bike. But yeah, this bike is definitely proving that it is to be reckoned with on the filthy streets. So now we're going to put it on the track and hopefully have a lot of fun with it there as well. gorgeous gauges. Have that flashing red anti-theft warning for you filthy thieves out there. Take a look at the beautiful TFT screen. That looks absolutely epic. I usually ride this motorcycle in race mode. It has several modes and the screen will change for the different modes. I like the bike in race mode. I have about 1,194 miles on the bike right now. And it is holding up very well. No issues to report at all. I'm gonna do a vlog on ownership of the V4 Speciale real soon on my channel, but I won't have anything striking to report. The bike did have a couple recalls and they were addressed before I even took possession of the motorcycle at Ducati Detroit. So that's never been a concern. That fan that you hear, it'll stay on even after you take the key out of the bike, as long as the computer senses that it needs to cool the bike off, which is pretty cool. This bike does not have the heat issues that my 1199 has and that Steve's 1299 also has. They are non-existent on the V4. I never get to show this. Let's take a look and see how the clear clutch cover looks when you start up the bike. So that'll wrap it up here for this beautiful evening. The V4 Speciale versus a ZX10, CBR1000RR, and a Turbo Busa. I think it was an outstanding racing series here. Apologies for not having my Whoop cam installed. I really wasn't expecting to engage in any racing, but it seems like whenever I bring this bike out, there's always somebody that wants to hand me or receive a smackdown. So go ahead and hit the like button if you enjoyed this video. You can subscribe to my channel by clicking the subscribe button. New videos are always uploaded to the channel. Stay tuned for more, guys. And as always, thanks so much for viewing. We'll catch you next time on the 650 EVE YouTube channel. I don't know which team to root for.